Your boy Donnie, Donald, DT. Everywhere they go through, all the gangsters around in that whole group. Nigga, what? I'm gonna have to go through. Because you can front if you want, you be popping them things. Oh, man. I know I'm making light of the situation. I'm just, this is like the internet. The internet, once something kind of crazy happens, but you turn out okay. The internet's like, time for these jokes. That's how the internet works. Because within 5 minutes, the internet had hella memes queued up already. Now, if you've been living under a rock, somebody tried to make an attempt on Donald Trump's life while he was speaking in Pennsylvania. Like, literally let off like 6 to 8 shots and looked like he got grazed in the ear. But in good old Donald Trump fashion, what did he do? Hold on, wait a second. Give me 1 second. Ah, Black Power Fist. Threw up the fist, people went crazy. I don't even know what to say about this situation. When I first saw the video, I was just like, hella shit just looked off. Let's start with this. Out the gate, Secret Service, you're fired. Matter of fact, y'all can't even get a job in security ever again. It'll be hard for y'all to get a job, period, after the display that y'all just showed on how to take care of a former president and presidential candidate. And it don't matter if you like Trump or not. That shit was just unacceptable from the Secret Service. Y'all are probably worse than the security guards at comedy clubs, at rap concerts. What's wrong with security in the past 5, 10 years? Like, when it comes to like trying to protect the person that is considered, I don't know, the important person or the prize or whatever the case may be, the entertainer, why is security late on protecting them? You've seen multiple comedians get attacked on stage and actually had to fight their way out of something or get thrown stuff at them. You've been seeing rappers get attacked on stage and security come out hella late. I gotta do a job? Nigga over here listening to the concert like this nigga J. Cole dope. I know the music's tight, fam, but you still got a job to do. You gotta tune out. All right, your job is to protect. So, like I said, whether you like Donnie or not, Secret Service dropped the damn ball. And all of them need to be like some type of extra background check about what they've been doing the past 6 months, if they've been making any calls, anything, because that shit was just hella weird. Them dudes was just way too slow. I wouldn't hire them to save anybody's life anymore. And what makes this even crazier, this was caught all on tape. So we all got to watch this play out in real time. That's the crazy part about this. And now with the internet and all the time that we had to look at stuff, there's been a lot of people out there that are just like analyzing the video and analyzing what's going on. And they're just like, something just seems a little off. You have people kind of looking to the side before it happens. There's supposedly reports that people were saying like, hey, there's somebody over there. Like there's somebody up there with a rifle, and they still didn't get to it on time. Now it looks like they ended up killing the dude. His name was Thomas Matthew Crooks. He was a 20-year-old or 20-something-year-old, actually Republican, because when things came out, that's the thing. With all these reports, when things are happening like this, immediately people are saying like, it had to be the Democratic side. They had to do it. And I ain't gonna lie, I thought so too with that aim, because if you got a target and you miss this badly over this many shots, you probably a Democrat. You probably can't hit a lick. That is not to say the Democrats can't shoot, because I'm sure they can, but have you seen the picture of this man? Just looking at him, he has the typical active shooter look, active school shooter prototype visual. And if I'm being honest, that's a lot of Donald Trump's fans. They all kind of look very similar. And now, for me personally, I just want to understand and know what was his agenda? Like, what was his point of doing this? If he's a Republican himself, and he's a young Republican at that, it seems like, he would be a Donald Trump fan. Why was he aiming to kill? And let me just add to this, fire the snipers too. You niggas was hella late, man. Like, all that whole crew, y'all gotta go, bro. Y'all gonna have to find another way to feed y'all families, nigga, because y'all did a terrible job. I know y'all ended up killing the kid, but still, at the end of the day, y'all was too slow on the draw. Now, there's some people out there that are calling this a possible false flag. And here's the thing, I'm not here to even fully argue that, to be honest with you, because this shit look hella suspect. But here's the thing, a lot of hypocrisy around that for me, because y'all weren't with that a few years ago when people were calling other things false flags. You're like, nah, this y'all trying to say something's a false flag. That's not real. All you little conspiracy theory and you little tin hat wearing motherfuckers. Nah, man, how could you even say something like this with these other things? It's like, look, man, Me personally, I don't put shit past America. I don't put shit past anybody with hella bread, to be honest with you. I don't fully trust you. Shit, I had a whole conspiracy theory show called Keenan's Conspiracy Theories. It was the best show on YouTube, if you want to be honest. It was with me and Tony Baker. We sat in a tent and we discussed conspiracy theories in a very hilarious way, but we talked about some serious things. So if you haven't, actually go watch that show. Just type in Keenan's Conspiracy Theories. But we talked about a whole bunch of different things like this. And look, the presidential run this year has been an absolute shit show. Like, Joe Biden has been sleepwalking this whole time. And Trump is an entertainer, dog. Like, he's been an entertainer for decades at this point. I don't put this past him for this possibly being a false flag incident. Now, that doesn't mean that shit wasn't real, because it's reported that somebody actually lost their life and I think others were injured. But if you're being honest, man, this country has no problem sacrificing their people to get a point across. You can look at previous incidents. I ain't even got to name the shits. I don't trust anybody. That's just me. I'm not telling you not to trust nobody, but for me personally, I don't trust none of y'all. Now, for me personally, I'm not super pro either side. I'm not a super pro Republican or Democrat. And if I'm being honest with you, when I see black people, specifically black people, ride too hard for either side, all I think of is that Tommy Davidson kind of like a clip from The Breakfast Club, and he goes, "Who are these niggas?" That's how I be looking at y'all, man. Neither one of these sides have had our best interest for decades. What I hate is, especially when you black, if you don't go super hardcore for Republicans, black people try to destroy you and be like, "You must be for the other side. You must be a conservative, blah, 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 blah." Hey, man, I don't fuck with none of these niggas. And when you go too hard, in all honesty, I can't trust you either, dog. Both of these parties have tried to kill us as a people. They have either said things to entice people to kill us, or they've actually put laws in place to kill us. That's both sides right there. So you can never get me to go hard on either side unless there's going to be a hard reset on both sides, essentially just depleting the shit and rebuilding it. Because at this particular point, I gotta go with my own instinct. I would never tell anybody who to vote for. I would never tell anybody who I'm voting for, because at the end of the day, you make your own decision. So I'm going to say this. Don't come to me for all your political advice, because I'm not that dude, all right? But if I was to say anything about it, specifically for black people, I'm not speaking for anybody else, specifically for us as a community, if we want to get any sort of thing done, at some point, we're going to have to leverage the bread as a black community and be like, "Hey, man, if you want our vote as a whole, or for at least as a majority, we got this much money. We need these things in place specifically for black people." I'm not talking about, "Well, this is going to open up the doors for everybody." Nah, fuck all that. Y'all don't put other bills in place specifically for other cultures and other races and other genders, all type of shit. We want specifically for black people. Here is the bread. You'll get it if you put these policies in place, or at least do a hard attempt to put these policies in place. If not, neither one of you niggas getting a vote. At the end of the day, and I know this is kind of a hard pill to swallow, we getting fucked regardless. That's the truth. You can try to fight me in the comment section, whatever the case may be. We are getting fucked as a black community regardless. It's shown throughout the past. You can't show me where we haven't gotten fucked at. You can't show me. Now, to go back to the Donald Trump shooting, right? I know people don't mess with Candace Owens like that. But here's the thing. She made an interesting point, right? And I know some people can't even listen to her, but that's why for me personally, I try to listen to all sides when it comes to certain things. And she had put up a video recently, like right after it happened, and she talked about something was off with the situation also, which I was surprised she even said that, because I just thought she'd be super hardcore. But she was like, "Nah, something's off." She did like and I'm paraphrasing here, so you can go watch her video about it. But I think she was doing like a speech for like the NRA or whatever, at the NRA. And she was talking about how her husband almost got shot by the Secret Service, because he was like coming down the stairs and they was like all over it, like fast. And she was like, "That doesn't seem right. Like they let some shit slide. Like something's off about the situation." And I think that's why people are saying this shit might be either a false flag situation or something's just off about it, because from what I remember, at least from what I read before or even heard about, like they do like a clean sweep within like a few miles of wherever these people are going to be speaking at. Where like somebody's this important, like a Donald Trump or Joe Biden, they usually do like a clean sweep of the area and the surrounding areas for any like suspicious spots. If they're like, "Yo, snipers could be here, here, and here, like in these particular areas, in these buildings, clean sweep this whole shit. And they usually go through that even before they speak, and up to weeks beforehand. They're knocking on people's doors. They're asking questions. They're probably even screening people's calls at that time. They know some shit's going to come down over here. They're probably like, everybody within a 5-mile radius, everybody's calls getting screened. And then for you to have this lackadaisical response and for this shit to happen, nah, bro. I think personally, after all this happened, this is going to at least boost Donald Trump's ego. Like, you motherfuckers tried to kill me. They tried to come for me and they couldn't do it. Like, he gonna be patting his chest hard. If I'm being honest with you, a lot of his fans gonna do the exact same thing. A lot of his supporters are gonna be out there like, see, they gonna go harder for him. Now, I know a lot of people didn't want to hear this because I've been seeing a lot of rumblings online saying like, well, after this happened, you know, he won. And then I've seen people push back and saying like, that's the dumbest shit you can say. You were idiot if you say something like that. No, that's not idiotic, actually. That's very, very not necessarily smart to say, but it makes sense. There's some people that are probably on the fence between who they're going to vote for. And after seeing something like this, they're going to be like, yo, man, like, this shit is crazy. Like, let's just, they might start to cast their vote on one side. Like I said, I'm not telling you who to vote for, but I also don't trust people that are super gung-ho when it comes to these candidates like that. I don't know. It's just a tricky conversation to have. And I think that there are just a lot of people that are misinformed and not as intelligent on politics as they think they are. I never sit there and act like I'm the most political person because I'm not. I never sit there and act like I dive into politics because I don't. And I got a lot of stuff to learn in that department. But I mean, on this podcast, I'm going to speak about the shit because it's my fucking podcast. So I'm going to speak about it. But I just know shit is going to get real, real weird going into November of this year.